story song?
Yes.
Oh, there you go. Yep, that's it.
That's it. I told you. I've never heard this band's name.
Was it called Del Evitri?
I don't know who the hell they are.
I'm gonna call it Del Amorite.
Amorite?
Hey, whoa!
I've never fucking heard of them.
What's happening?
Are we on?
We're playing. Yeah, we're doing it. Okay. We're live. We're going.
Hey, I'm fucking gay.
Boing, boing.
I was hoping you would
yes.
participate.
Oh, I left the remote all the way over there.
Oh no. Welcome back to
another episode of Vic and Hope.
Sticks and
what?
I don't know.
Sticks and stones may break my bones. We're playing Skyward Sword.
Whoa! Playing tennis on the Wii.
Yeah, it's been like literally months since I've played Sekiro now, so I figured
we're abandoning Sekiro.
Yeah,
because we can't complete anything in
at this
life.
Point. I mean, maybe if I start playing it again and beat the game, we could go back and do it.
Yeah,
but right
but you
now
have, you like, have better things to play now, like Minecraft.
True. I've been playing Minecraft. I guess let's just launch right into Minecraft, dude.
Hey.
Minecraft has seen a resurgence because of PewDiePie. I'm
Very
sure everyone fucking knows.
So.
But like, he just makes it look so fun, and
because
I can never get into.
Because he builds a story.
Yeah.
It's really just PewDiePie's pet simulator.
Yes. Of course, we're gonna do the green one. That's obviously the
Why?
Best one.
Why? Because green for...
Link,
green,
what the fuck?
G for gay? Everybody knows his name is Zelda.
True. Should I name myself Zelda?
Yes.
Well, why would I name myself Zelda when I could name myself... Fago!
Fagoni!
Wait, how do I make it so it's very clear that it's fag... There we go. Fag-o.
Fago!
Jumping into it.
It's not that funny.
Vic and Hope, Skyward Sword, Episode 1. Legend of Fago. Here we go.
What's the horse's name gonna be?
Fago?
Fago and Fago.
Fago 2? Oh no, what's that? It's a scary boy.
Oh shit, it's a worm. That's what worms look like.
That is what worms look like. It's a Ganon worm.
They have big old teeth.
He's very mad. So we're playing Skyward Sword.
Yeah,
I never
this is not
like
Minecraft.
I've maybe made it like 50% through this game before.
Oh, good.
Because I never owned it. I played Shade's old shitty friend Alan's copy of it, and I didn't like it that much. So.
Oh, so we bought it so that you could finish
yes.
it.
So we bought it so I could finally finish it because I've always wanted to finish it because it was probably. I feel like I was, you know. At that time, we were all too negative on Skyward Sword, and maybe it's a great game. I don't know. But here we are, experiencing it together for the first time.
I hope you're ready to be Skyward.
God, this looks like
bored.
Just a pixelated nightmare.
It's pretty bad.
It's the best that we had to offer at the time.
Yeah, that's very true.
I feel like Twilight Princess looked better than this game, but, you know, fuck me.
This is pretty pixely.
Maybe it's because we're playing it through the Wii U, so it's like...
Maybe.
Jacked up? I don't know. I thought the Wii would upscale games and make them look better.
Maybe...
This definitely looks like fucking turd.
I don't know. Whoa, he just
got
ate
it.
Her hand.
No, he got the letter.
No, he took her hand with
he's,
it.
He's...
She,
he's
that bitch ate her hand. Up. Her hand's gone.
Yeah, so I never beat this game. Have you ever seen anything of this game?
I don't know shit about this game.
This game has, like, the most story of all Zelda. Because this is the game where they retconned the Zelda timeline... It established that? Did
yeah.
you know that there was a Zelda timeline?
I'm vaguely aware of this.
Because this game is the first one in the sequence. This is the origin of the Zelda story. And there's just, like, assloads of story and cutscenes. Which is another reason why it's hard to play.
I mean, it's got a big worm, so it can't be that bad. Rise, Fago!
The time has come for you to awaken.
You betcha.
Awaken, 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 awaken. Take the land that must be taken. You remember, I showed Hope a few episodes of Death Clock.
Yeah,
you remember what that's
like
from.
Like two episodes.
Yeah. Oh, God. See, this is just going to take forever. Are these even skippable? They're
that's
not.
That's a good question. Oh, Jesus.
Yep.
Well, you know what that means. Nintendo's going to claim our ass.
Oh, true.
It's weird seeing Link without the ponytail now. Because I'm like, wait,
oh,
Link has
Breath of the
hair.
Wild Link.
Yeah. I'm so used to it now.
He is a much better, like, Link in this game looks like shit with this stupid outfit.
Link in this game is not the best.
It's just aesthetically the worst, like, 3D Zelda game. When you're coming off, like, Twilight Princess had that great gritty aesthetic, Wind Waker had the great cartoony aesthetic, and this is just a weird in-between that's not quite there yet.
It's right in between the two, but it's
like,
not,
look at his face. It's so awkward. I'm glad they went kind of back to classic Link face with Breath of the Wild and then just changed the aesthetic in a better way.
Yeah. Were they going for, like, more pretty boy Link in this?
I don't know.
What's the deal?
It's weird. I'm wondering if it's just, like, they're trying to make
it almost
it look
looks like
older.
He's more anime than I've ever seen him be.
Night look at Academy? His awkward walk. Like, he looks like such a fucking doofus.
Yeah, he looks like a fucking someone you'd shove into a locker at the Night Academy. So he's a knight?
And then you're just, like, walking around.
Whoa, why is that chair so, like, small compared to the table? Look at that. Look at the proportions.
That's probably normal.
No, look at that. Look how big the table looks compared to... His feet are touching the ground on the chair!
I mean, this is fucked. The table, I think it's just the table is huge.
I mean, the table's huge.
And Link is very small, I guess.
I guess.
It does feel like, looking
Isn't
at Link
like
sitting in this
hilarious
chair.
Hilarious proportion. I don't know, it just seems so weird.
It is awkward that his feet aren't touching the ground.
He looks like a child.
He looks very tiny in this chair. He's not even close to the back of the chair.
No, that's what it looks like he's sitting in, like, an exhibit in the Ripley's Believe It or Not Museum that's, like, world's biggest chair.
I suppose.
It's like, okay.
There you go. Skyward Sword is clearly trash. They can't even nail the proportions of
Link.
Can't
even get chair designs right.
Oh, I've got a closet. I found a rupee in my closet.
Oh, nice.
God,
like
Link's
a
such
real
a fucking...
Jew.
Look at this dork. Look at his shit. Is that a pennant? Do you have
a
fucking
pennant
flag?
Yes, there's a pennant in
there. Are you kidding
me? Two pennants.
What a fucking
doofus.
He's
gonna have to commit some penance after keeping all those pennants.
Look at this stupid house and his stupid plant.
You should
Fuck
knock
this
that
lake.
Plant off the...
I'm glad I named him Faggo because that's...
This is truly Faggo.
Sums him up perfectly.
Yup.
Fucking Faggo Link.
This is... Definitely the gayest iteration of Link that I've ever seen.
I'm just strolling around.
Oh, God. Ew.
Good morning, Faggo. So, today's the wing ceremony. Are you ready?
Oh,
this is the Let's Play where we just become normal Let's Players and all we do is voices and just yell.
Yes. You
now,
are so
I mean,
easy
we're
going.
Always just yelling, but normally we're yelling about something and now we're just yelling in general. That's
game.
How this Let's Play is going to go.
Yeah.
Because you can't skip the cutscenes in this game and the text crawl is very slow, so...
This is a game about birds, which intrinsically makes me hate
Ooh,
it.
Ooh, my map. I am enjoying playing with the Wiimote because it's been ages. Woo, woo.
Woo, woo, woo.
Let's see, do I have a, like, menu? Or I can change the text speed?
Oh god, I fucking hope so. That would make life much easier, to be honest.
Not help.
To be fair.
Whoa. Very helpful.
Okay.
Well, I mean, this is helping.
You're right. Help. Help, I need an adult. Help.
This is your run. Like, this is Link
Whoa.
Walking. This is Link running.
Oh, no!
It's the same animation. He just gets slightly faster.
Oh.
They didn't
that's...
even change his running animation. Ooh, I can roll. How
We're
going
to be
that?
Rolling a lot, I have a feeling.
I think I got to, like, wiggle? I got to wiggle the nunchuck, I think.
Well, of course. How else would
Lock
you
on.
Initiate rolling?
Look. Look! Listen! Look! Listen! Oh.
What is this guy?
What an asshole.
Is he trying to take shit?
Let's well, I could be like first person play.
Nice.
Morning, Faggo.
Morning,
Faggo. Today's the big wig ceremony, right? Oh, wait, this guy's going to. I wanted to fly too, but I didn't make the cut, so I'm stuck back here at the academy. Oh my god, I cannot care.
They just assigned this idiot to move barrels. Okay. Maybe you were too beta to get into the wing ceremony. Aw,
shit. Whoa, it feels like I'm really throwing the vases because I'm swinging the Wiimote to throw them. It's
Whoa.
Like I'm really Link. This
motion
is crazy. The Wii Motion
Control.
Plus has truly changed the game. Oh, I helped him. I'm busy. No problem.
Right. No problem.
Like these actions have consequences anyways.
Right.
I need to carry one of these barrels. The old lady works in the kitchen.
Great. Yeah, I kind of already picked up on how to put the barrel I'm already in holding my arms. It. Thank you.
And swing it. You can throw wherever you're carrying. You can roll small items like pots by holding the Wiimote down and swinging it. What? Like you're barreling. Whoa, crazy. I'm glad I talked to this guy.
Throw the barrel. Fuck this guy.
Press 2 to do what? Oh, bring up your tutorial.
Throw it.
I'm gonna fucking... Oh no, my stamina's running down. Where's the kitchen?
Uh-oh. Just throw it. Fuck it. I'm just gonna go in here. Who gives a shit?
Because I wanna give it to the old lady and see if I get some stuff.
No, this guy is an idiot and he doesn't deserve our help.
I mean, he is a jackass. He is basically gay.
What happens when your stamina runs out?
I probably dropped the barrel on my head.
Nice. Let's see. I'm quite intrigued.
There's this old lady.
Nothing really happens.
The animations in this game are the worst.
Yeah, they're pretty disgusting.
Yep.
Yep.
How do I bullet? I'm holding the Wiimote down.
How do you bullet?
I can't bullet.
I think you can only roll small things.
Oh, the small things. That's a lady. Goddamn.
Wow, sexist, first of all.
Jesus.
You know, not all of us can age gracefully. Yeah. Some of us need to go ahead and use the aging face app in order to determine what we're going to look like in 30 years.
It drives me insane.
That way the Russians can have our facial data and can deep fake us into their weird Russian porn.
I think you know you're a normie if you're using that fucking app. Like, if you've used that app and aged your face, you're a fucking normie. Have you done it?
No.
Are you looking? Okay. I'm just making sure.
I thought it was funny.
I didn't think you
Victor,
would.
I'm not going to give the Russians my fucking facial data without a fight.
It's the ultimate fucking, fucking blue pill normie thing to do is use that fucking app. Especially if you make that face your fucking profile picture.
What?
Just
do people do
go.
That?
Yes. Fucking Arn.
Oh, well, of course, it's Arn.
Fucking people aging their face and making it their profile picture. Fuck you.
That does not surprise me in the least. That being said, I did put your picture in the face.
Oh, fuck, am I gonna get arrested? Did you?
No, I'm fucking with you.
How did I look? Do I look handsome? Do I look like Larry David? And it's one of those where it's just like, first of all, it's just gathering your information to give to Russian spies so that they can further the progress of their fucking deepfake technology. Fucking idiots.
When you
end fucking
up in a
sheeple.
Russian porn,
what's wrong
know.
With you? Why would you fucking do this? Second of all, it just gives everyone like the kind of same generic face anyways. Sort of like the Snapchat one where it made people into a woman, but like everyone was the same
woman. Everyone was the same lady. Yeah.
I'd say this one's a little bit better than
that.
It generally goes for like the same lines on the face and stuff, you know?
Well, I mean, it's an algorithm, you know?
Yeah.
It applies the same shit to everybody. Your face just has different contours and stuff.
So fucking... People just love it! They just eat it up!
I don't understand. I don't understand how people aren't suspicious of that shit.
Yeah.
Like, how are you not wary of a app that is collecting tremendous amounts of facial data?
Yeah.
Like, that's some scary shit. Especially when you don't know where it's coming
in
from.
In fucking 2019, where you know... Every app you download, they're fucking getting access to your camera, getting all of this information about you, getting your email, your phone number, all this fucking bullshit, and then they're also now gathering your facial data. Oh wait, he does have a new animation for running.
Maybe you weren't supposed to.
Yeah, it's only
before,
when you're inside.
And now,
I was inside, now I'm outside. So he.
I mean, that
outside.
Running animation it is, still looks like ass.
It still looks like shit. Maybe when I get a sword, it'll look different, and that's why it's so bad.
We can hope so.
But yeah. Anyways. In fucking 2019, if you don't have the common sense to not use this fucking sketchy app made by Russians, then just, I don't know what to do with you. You're a fucking dipshit.
Exactly.
Oh my god, that's right, you have to save its statues in this game. God, why? Why would they do that to us?
That seems pretty obnoxious.
So fucking stupid. It's Zelda. I should be able to save wherever the fuck I want.
Not anymore.
Oh, I guess I gotta climb up to this fucking douchebag, but he won't let me climb up here. Okay, I gotta Z-target him and talk. Fuck.
Oh, Jesus.
How many of these games have I played where I had to fucking Z-target and talk to somebody?
All of them?
Fuck. Fucking asshole.
Except for, you know...
Oh my god, the text crawl.
Yeah, it's painful.
Jesus. Oh. Yo, I climbed up the wooden box! Wow, I never would have thought to do that, asshole. Fucking
and lightning. Thank you, sensei.
Asshat. douchebag. His voice is so deep. Whoa, I can use A to dash? Who would have thought?
Holy shit.
It's almost like there's a giant Wiimote on my fucking screen at all times reminding me where the fucking A button is.
Thanks, Nintendo. Thanks, Shigeru Miyamoto.
Wow, genius fucking interface. There's just a big-ass Wiimote on my screen at all times. It doesn't.
It doesn't?
It just stays there.
It stays here the whole game?
Yes.
How?
There's a full-size... It's bigger than the Wiimote in my hand.
It's bigger than your actual Wiimote.
And it's permanently on the screen.
I don't understand how you can ruin the aesthetic of your game by adding that.
Yeah,
overlay.
It just completely takes you out of it because there's literally a Wiimote on your screen. Why does it need to be in the shape of a Wiimote on your fucking screen? Maybe eventually I'll get a settings menu where I can change it, but goddamn.
That's pretty bad.
I don't need the whole Wiimote. Put it in the top right corner or something where it just says a button, like on the N64.
Yeah, why
you know?
Do you need to have it front and center like that and be a big ass Wiimote? Like, relax, dude. We get it. We're playing things on the Wii.
Why does it even give me the choice of saying I'm busy or I'm on it?
Right. Well, I mean, choice is artificial, so...
Exactly.
Everything is preordained.
He's just gonna ask me again.
Alright.
Doo-doo-doo.
Let's fucking go.
Alright.
Oh my god.
Let's do it.
Alright, let's see that shit.
I'm a real Let's Player now.
Oh, for sure.
It's so goofy. It looks like a Disney game.
It does. Oh no.
How do I leap? There we go.
This color palette is pretty off-putting.
I mean, it's
personally.
Like, kind of fine, but kind of like, no.
It's just, yeah, it just feels like I'm looking at, like, Tangled or something. Not that Tangled
like,
is a bad movie,
it feels like
that's
some
just what it feels like.
3D Winnie the Pooh game.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, nice. Am I off to the Hundred Acre Woods?
Sick. I'm not a fucking baby. I'm
Where's
not
Christopher
playing Winnie
Robin,
the Pooh.
Dog? Hey,
oh,
faggo!
Jesus. Yeah, okay. What? Buddy, just let us do the thing, please.
Anywho, so I've been playing Minecraft.
Yes, so you've been playing Minecraft
PewDiePie's been playing
because
it.
You want to pretend you're a Zoomer.
And, like, I never got the appeal growing up because I just didn't understand, like, what the fuck there is to really do in the game besides dig. And so now
Everybody's
I understand because I watched PewDiePie play and I looked at his house and stuff. I was like, oh, this looks cool and fun and everything he's doing is neat. So I've been playing it, and I mean, I suck ass at it. That's the real problem. What the fuck?
Throw her off the house.
What is this fucking avatar?
Throw
what
her,
the hell is this
throw
thing?
Throw her into the abyss, please.
God damn it.
God, you- How dare you eliminate my option to throw this creature off of this fucking floating
right.
village?
There's just no freedom at all. This is ugly as sin.
Yeah, this guy sucks
What the fuck
ass.
Is this thing?
This is like- Zaboomafoo if it was a Final Fantasy character.
It feels like some stupid shit in Avatar.
The Listen last to Airbender. The noise it's making. It's making cat noises.
Meow.
You're not a cat!
Meow.
You're a lemur thing!
LOL, we took two animals and combined them together
Ho-ho.
To make a new animal. This is very original.
Verily,
ooh,
I have never seen
I got
anything
as fruit.
Unique and interesting.
Sick.
And it sits like a fucking dog. Okay, whatever.
Where did that fucking guy go?
He was a... No, you went too far. Go
I
back.
Okay, I gotta go back. Well,
yeah.
I'm just gonna carry this throughout the whole game. There's Zelda over there.
Well, I mean...
Eh.
You don't need a sword. You just need this guy. Anyway, you're playing Minecraft.
I should do the lyrics. Yeah, I've been playing Minecraft. I don't even know where I'm going with that. I'm just bad at Minecraft.
Oh, okay.
I'm having fun. But then, like, I keep dying in lava and lose all my shit. If I feel like it's a game for, like, people with severe OCD who need to, like, be extremely organized with everything they do to be very efficient. I'm watching some online videos of a dude who is a fucking psychopath, and he just makes all these crazy fucking human farms and shit in the game. I'm like, this is a game for fucking crazy people. Why? I don't want this guy to tell me what happens at night. This guy fucking touches little kids.
What the fuck? Is he saying this little thing becomes a monster at night?
That's fucking gay.
Okay.
This game sucks.
What is this, Gremlins? Like,
it's fucking
okay,
Gremlin.
What? That sucks.
Ugh.
How unbelievably tedious.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just playing Minecraft to tide me over till Fire Emblem comes out.
Yeah.
Which will be, like, next Friday.
The game in which you can fuck your students.
Yeah, so I can fuck all my students. Exactly. That's all. That's why I got into Fire Emblem.
So
back when I was, like, eight or nine years old, I got hard into Fire Emblem because I could be a teacher and fuck my students, and I could walk around and pretend I'm playing Persona. That's why I'm into Fire Emblem. That's, you know, that's been the appeal the whole time.
But, like, Victor, one of the guys is bisexual, so it's
Being gay, that's why I'm into Fire Emblem, totally.
Being gay?
I've always been into the gayness and the moe girls. This is why I'm into this franchise. You know, it wasn't the awesome pixel art, sweet background music, dudes with axes and stuff. I could have a guy who was a villager, and then I
Zelda
can train
bad.
Him, and I can turn him into a pirate, and then from a pirate, I can turn him into a berserker, where he has a giant axe and a bow, and he fucks people up, and he becomes the best. That's not why I was into the game. I was into it because I wanted to date a fucking gay man and fucking have a child that travels back in time to be my troop. That's why I was into Fire Emblem.
Yes. Victor. What do you think about this iteration of Zelda?
Oh, she's fucking hideous.
Yeah.
Look at her nose and lips.
Her
Why?
Lips really bother me a lot, actually.
Like, it doesn't look like a Zelda game. It looks so weird.
It's super bizarre, and I don't like it.
Nice
it
costume.
Makes me uncomfortable.
Great. I think
we're gonna
go with
is what everybody's thinking.
She just looks like total ass.
Yeah, I mean, the outfit's not good, the face is not good.
The outfit and the hair could be alright if her face looked, like, acceptable at all.
Yeah. Her hair doesn't bother me.
Yeah.
It's her face, mostly.
She just Zelda's looks like such a doofy dad. Dipshit. Nice.
Whoa!
I'm the king of Hyrule! Oh my god. Can't get through this shit.
There certainly is a lot of talking in this game.
Link just looks so weird. It's just... They look like off-brand Disney characters. I hate it.
Yeah, this is not my favorite.
Oh, man. We're just really ripping into this shit. We're just gonna have to get through all of this in one episode.
Get
all
on
this
with
bullshit.
It.
There's no way to skip it.
I know.
You just can't do it.
It's
I keep
not your
pressing
fault.
Every button I can find.
I mean,
this was a terrible idea,
whose
huh?
brilliant idea was it to not make the cutscenes skippable?
Fucking Shigeru Miyamoto.
Thanks, Miyamoto! Why don't you go design another fucking dogs game?
God.
We need more Nintendogs, not this.
Gee, I wonder why it was so hard for me to get into this fucking game. Because you start off immediately disinterested and hating it. So how are you supposed to get into it? This is like...
It's like, if we hate it this much now, I can't imagine you 10 years ago would have enjoyed this.
This must be how Conrad feels playing Twilight Princess, because he hates it so much in the beginning. And I'm just like, this fucking sucks hard.
This is just... Ugh. Fuck. Oh, I hate looking at her face. Oh.
What's with her bloodshot eyes?
Right? Maybe she smoked
Everyone,
the ganja before
Everyone's
this.
Fucking high as fuck in this game.
You have to be
His
high
weird face wrinkles.
To appreciate this shit.
Who thought that face was okay? Look at,
like,
that face!
I mean, it's okay if you want to give your character, like, a tired facial expression by, like, adding the lines under their
but
eyes and stuff.
The dick
but
sucking lips and the weird
the lips
nose,
really
like...
are where I draw the line at a hard no.
Like, I think they wanted to have, like, an adult Link that looked more expressive, but, like,
this
bad.
Ugh. Oh, fuck.
Zelda just sucks in this game.
I don't care. Get on with it. Whoa. That was a pretty good burp.
This is one where they needed fucking voice acting in this game, because it's so boring.
It's like, if you're gonna make me sit here and watch this, at least, you know, give me something to interact with.
Oh god, it's like Garzy's wing, but worse.
I was actually thinking that same thing.
Yes.
I'm going to the class reunion pool party. I'll be back in 2 days.
Oh my god.
Fuck, we get it! There's birds here! And you ride the fucking birds. Ah!
Man, I need to do, like, what we have been doing with Vinland Saga.
Which is play Viking melodic death metal over everything.
Yes. Because fucking they made the Vinland Saga anime, and we watched the first three episodes, and the opening of that show is awful. It's fucking horrible. So you just mute it, and you play, like, Amon Amarth and Falkenbach over it.
Falcon.
And then it becomes a fucking great opening, because the actual opening itself is really well done.
Yeah.
It's a great opening sequence. It's just such a shitty song.
They just chose the worst possible song to go with it.
It feels so off-genre. Really stupid. Wow, great scene.
Whoa, cool.
Oh, the bird got me and he brought me back up. This
that
makes
bird
me want
sure
to die.
Did save my life.
This is worse than Star Fox Adventures.
At least you want to fuck Crystal in Star
exactly.
Fox
Adventures. Exactly. You don't even want to fuck with Zelda. It's not even a hot furry for you to fuck in this game.
Oh, God.
Holy shit, dude.
Oh, I'm sorry we are floundering, but this is really interminable.
Maybe we need to just, like...
Oh.
Just wait it out and then cut it all out of the video. I don't know. Or do you want to just start talking? Just talk about
something. I
guess
let's just do it.
Let's
right?
just have a conversation
let's
while I skip through this shit.
Let's just jump into
it. It's not like we're reading it.
Yeah. I guess you're right. Well, speaking of furries that you want to fuck, I guess, let's talk about the Cats trailer.
What is there to say beyond that it's disgusting and abhorrent?
I mean,
it's worse than Sonic. I don't know.
I mean, I just think it's a very interesting phenomena because it's absolutely aesthetically a nightmare.
Yes.
Yet there are girls who are going to go see it because it has Taylor Swift in it.
Yes.
And the girls who are going to see it just because Taylor Swift is in it are all complaining about how there's going to be furries in the theater jacking off to Cats. And it's like, no. This aesthetic is not
yes.
what furries are wanting from
well,
a movie.
Even if it is.
It's not.
Furries could jack off at home, for one. I don't know why they have to go to the... Like, it's that statement implies that there isn't an abundance of furry
right?
porn literally everywhere. Like, what do you furries need this to go
right?
jack off to?
They have to go watch Cats to get off?
What the fuck?
Sure.
Second of all,
why
yeah,
not?
Furries are into, like, goofy, Looney Tune fucking anthropomorphic shit. They're not into literal people that are cats.
They don't want to see literal humans with real fur technology, TM.
It's a super huge misunderstanding of aesthetic.
It's hilariously stupid.
Fucking awful.
Andrew Lloyd Webber, thank you for this gift.
I'm wondering if CGI has gotten to a point where it's so good that it's looking awful.
That's the problem.
Because, like, it looks fucking creepy and terrible, but it doesn't look terrible in the way that it's, like, a bad rendering of CGI.
Yeah.
You know? Like, it does look good in a sense where, like, you know all the fucking follicles of hair
yes.
are all fucking
like,
there and real, but, like...
technically, it is well done.
But it looks bad because it's... aesthetically terribly designed and it's lit incredibly brightly, you know?
Yeah.
Like, CGI stuff has always tried to shy away from showing you anything because when it shows you too much, it starts to look stupid.
Yeah, I hate to...
Or terrible.
Yeah. I mean, definitely, I agree because nowadays CGI is, like, so good that no one bothers to try to hide anything, so
yeah.
it's all just out and about and there's a huge abundance of it. And there's nothing, like, there's nothing restraining anybody, so everything is just, like, they just do whatever, you know? There's no boundary to stay within that promotes creativity from restrictions. It's just, I have this horrible vision, and I can bring it to life because CGI will let me.
And it's, like, what's even weirder is just, like, you know, you've got people with faces, but they don't have eyebrows. You've got... the fact that they're small, they're supposed to be the size of normal cats.
But, like, their size is really inconsistent.
Yeah. And it looks stupid and awful and creepy. You just never get in the sense, like, I've seen Cats the play, it's awful and I hate it. I hate it passionately. What am I supposed to be doing? Okay, I need to read this.
She's not coming with you is all she's saying.
Okay.
Go and ask if anyone in town knows what happened to your loft.
Oh my god. No. I have to read.
Fuck.
Anyways,
reading.
I've seen Cats the Musical. It's horrible and stupid, and you have no idea what's going on the entire time. It's aesthetically terrible and annoying. And so they make a movie out of it, and it's like, watching Cats the Musical, you don't get the impression that these are literally cats in the real world, I guess, you know?
Yeah.
You don't get the impression that they are the size of normal cats. Like, you're just not really thinking about it, it's just kind of a thing. And then they show you the movie, and it's like, what the fuck is this?
There's a scene where, like, the main cat girl is holding a fork and a knife, and the fork and the knife are, like, as big as her entire body? It's like, how big is she? Is she 5 inches tall? Cats aren't 5 inches tall.
Yeah.
What is going on here? I'm so confused.
I think it's that, like, they are the height of a cat from the ground to the top of a cat's back, you know?
But that makes them tiny,
but they
proportionally.
Aren't proportionally the size of a cat. Because they're only proportionally the size of a cat height-wise and not their whole body. Like, it's not like if it were a cat standing on its hind legs and were the size of a cat standing on its hind legs.
Yeah, but that would make more sense.
They're the size of a cat from foot to back, you know?
See, but here's where it gets fucky. Because there's times when they're standing on, they're bipedal, and they're like 5 inches tall, and then from that point, I can understand your argument of them being the height of a real cat, which is a quadruped. However, there's also scenes where the human cats are running on all fours, and at that point, they'd be like 2.5 inches tall.
Yes.
And then at that rate, why didn't you just make them proportionate to a real cat? I don't understand. Why do they need to be tiny? It's so weird. Why is she the size of a knife?
She's immensely retarded.
Help! I need an adult.
Got overcompensating vocal performances. It's gonna have annoying, shitty acting.
Oh, God.
We definitely gotta go see it.
I mean, we have to see it. It's gonna be a nightmare.
Yes.
It's got Rebel Wilson as a obese cat, and that's funny.
Who is that? Oh, yeah, that stupid fat woman. Yeah.
That's her joke.
That's
she's
her
fat.
Job. I'm fat.
That's funny.
And a lady. And so other ladies love me. Stupid normie
girls
ladies.
Girls like me because I'm not a threat. She's
well,
fat,
no.
So dudes won't want
to
fuck her.
It's not because she's not a threat. It's because she's relatable to fat-ass girls.
Yeah, but thin girls can like her because she's not competition.
Yeah, well, that's because thin girls all perceive themselves as being her. Because all girls think that they're fat.
Take a shit!
And all girls think that they're edgy. And all girls think that they're
true.
Not normal.
Yep.
All girls, 100%.
I'm not like other girls.
All
y'all.
Girls are not like other girls. All girls are fat. So she's relatable to literally everyone.
It's true. Every girl in the world does think she's edgy.
Exactly. Every girl
My
is
mom
not like
included.
Other girls. I'm not a princess. Or, I'm different because I am a princess. I'm just a girly girl. I'm not like other girls, because no girls are girly girls.
No girls are anything. Girls aren't real. Girls are a figment of
our imagination.
Girls
are a social construct. Save.
Just remember, girls aren't real.
Better save at the bird statue so I don't have to sit through all this bullshit again.
Everyone is actually just dudes.
Yes, everyone is a guy. It's just, are you a guy with a vagina or a guy with a dick?
That's
it.
Girls are an artificial construct.
Are you a guy with tits or a guy with a cock? Or a guy with tits and a cock?
The Russians created the construct of girls.
Yes, it was all the Russians.
Like ass. Fuck. Oh, jeez.
Can't fucking trust anything anymore because the Russians are meddling in everything.
Exactly.
It's the Cold War all over again, except it's happening on fucking Facebook, and your mom is the one fucking buying into it. Your mom is the one ruining America. Oh my god, I hate this
Make
so
America
much.
Make America moms again.
This is the worst idea. I just spent like $60 to buy this game and a Wiimote and a sensor bar and a nunchuck because I couldn't fucking find any of those things. And here I am, suffering through the worst start of a game of all time.
This is really, really bad.
Where I walk around with this fucking dipshit Chad. Oh my god.
Fuck.
Talking about cats. Hey, what we're drinking, I'm drinking a ginger beer, and that's nice.
Ginger
You're not drinking yet, are you?
Beer,
Can we get a drink? What's wrong with you?
Okay.
We're supposed to be drinking.
Well,
this is a drinking day. And then we're gonna play Until Dawn, so that we can actually enjoy that and not do a Let's Play. Because we're on a meme. Hope's going to get a drink, and it's just me. Like, comment, and subscribe if this is the shittiest fucking Let's Play ever made. Oh my god. Ooh, things are so muddy in the distance. It's beautiful. Look at that. Look at that over there. That looks great.
That's nice. I'll take 10.
I guess it's nice that I can see anything.
Alright, boys.
The Wii was such a shit console for graphical capabilities. It literally looked worse than the GameCube. I don't understand. How is it possible?
Alright, y'all. I'm cracking open a ruby grapefruit White Claw. So feel free to send me some clout.
Sick, bro. Hope thinks that White Claws are like a bro Instagram
clout
bro
chaser
thing,
drink.
Clout chaser drink. Yeah. So let me know in the comments if that is true or not, because I don't have any frame of reference for White Claws being a bro drink.
That's what all the Instagram influencers drink, dude.
I suppose. How many Instagram influencers do you follow?
It's just a meme, dude.
Is it?
Yeah.
Where is
on
this
Twitter.
Meme? On Twitter?
Yeah.
I see. I've never seen this meme.
Dude, yeah. That's because you are not in the meme culture in Twitter.
Clearly. All I follow is, like, YMS, who follows Jeff Thu. So, the only
so
person...
Really follow
the
Jeff
only
Thu.
Person I follow on Twitter is Jeff Thu. Mother's Basement. It's great. I love it. Oh, I love seeing every single tweet from Mother's Basement because YMS likes every single one of his tweets. So, it's basically like I'm following him.
Why does YMS like him so much?
I don't know, because YMS is a fucking idiot and a stupid normie cuck. That's
not,
why.
Not wrong.
Because YMS fucking sucks.
But hey, YMS did give the Lighthouse a 10.
Yeah.
So, there is that.
I mean, we don't... You know, we gotta see the Lighthouse to know if that's bullshit or not.
Yeah, but, like, I have no reason to believe the White House would... The White House.
The White House, yes.
The Lighthouse wouldn't be good. You know? I'm excited. I need a release date, A24. Give me a release date.
He also... His favorite movie is Sid Next to Key, New York, so, like...
Okay,
you haven't
yeah,
seen
that's
that
fair.
Yet, but,
And the last movie he gave a 10 to was fucking The Revenant.
Really?
Yeah. He gave a 10 to The Revenant, remember?
Yeah. YMS is stupid.
His taste is kind of shit sometimes.
Yeah.
The
Revenant's good. It's just not, you know.
The Revenant just isn't a movie you can, like, casually watch.
It's a regular movie.
It's a lot.
It's not particularly unique, I suppose.
Yeah.
In terms of plot.
No.
This is a guy,
really.
And he's
I mean, it's
sucked.
Technically impressive, and I guess that's why it's a good movie, but...
Because it's objectively perfect, you know?
Yeah,
objectively.
Definitely.
There's no flaws.
Look how tiny Link looks next to the big lady.
Yeah, that is a big lady.
A giant woman, one
oh,
might even
man.
Say.
What am I doing? I'm literally just talking to villagers.
Speaking of the Lighthouse... Yeah.
Yes.
We went to see Midsommar.
Yeah.
What did you think about Midsommar?
I liked it a bunch.
Yeah?
I've got to hear everyone else's. Everyone just kind of generally really likes it. And I'm like, all right, it was a good movie. And that's, you know.
Yeah.
It didn't change my life.
Well, of course. But the best part was we went to see it the night that it opened because I didn't have to work the next day.
Yes.
So we went to like a 7:30 showing the night that it opened. Oh, this guy looks scary.
Yep.
This guy looks like a fucking Chuck E. Cheese mascot.
I hope you're ready to deal with a bunch of this fucking guy. Because for some reason they thought he was hilarious. And
I'm
so here
quite
he is.
Nervous. This makes me uncomfortable.
Whoa, it's the Crystal Gems.
Oh,
here we
no.
go.
Oh, no. Fuck me. Oh. This.
And here you are,
this
witnessing.
Makes Breath of the Wild look so fucking good.
Right?
Oh, my
now
God.
Now you understand. You finally understand Skyward Sword.
I wanna die.
You finally understand the worst Zelda game ever.
No, don't look at me with those evil eyes.
This
oh,
is why.
Fuck. Shit. Oh my God!
You have to
People
suffer
cosplay
through so
this guy.
Much shit. Oh God, they do. You're
yeah!
right.
Yeah, what
it's
the
always
fuck?
Girls.
Dude looks like a fucking freak. He looks like he would rape you and your mom. What is wrong with people? Oh,
he is fucking crazy.
Oh my
shit.
God, this is nightmare fuel. Fuck this. Oh God.
Hope, how can you make fun of a transgender like that?
He's not transgender. What
Are
the
you sure?
fuck? Shut the fuck up!
Dude looks like a lady!
Oh my god. Whatever.
He's so gross.
He's so gross. Listen here, you piece of shit. I'll murder you. Anyway.
I think she looks okay right there in this one frame.
Wow. One shot in which Zelda looks okay when she's put next to a fucking clown.
Oh, this is suffering. I just. Why would you interpret Zelda
this way? Yeah, like, she
looks
okay here, but...
Why would you turn The Legend of Zelda into a generic high school, like, group dynamic comedy?
Oh my god, I want to die. Ew.
This is, Zelda Isekai.
Yeah, I'm gonna need to keep drinking if we're gonna play this.
Every frame of this is poison. Oh
All
my
right.
god.
This grapefruit White Claw is pretty good. Anyway.
Then we have a sip.
You're not gonna like it.
I know. That's why I got ginger beers.
I know.
I like it.
Yo, do you?
It's way better than seltzer water. Guys, let me know if you like fucking LaCroix and Perrier's and fucking gross-ass seltzer waters, because they're the most disgusting thing ever. I just can't get into them at all. Literally, I have enjoyed the taste of beer significantly more since drinking seltzer waters. Because they're so much better than that.
No.
I've gotten used to beer, and I can't get used to seltzer waters. They're fucking gross.
No. I would drink seltzer water any day. All right,
what the fuck am
beer.
I doing now? God damn it. You gotta pay so much attention to this shit.
Yeah. Though I will say, the day that we had lunch with Dick Masterson, the beer he bought us then was pretty all right.
Yeah, because he has good taste, and he doesn't buy a shitty fucking IPA. That's the problem, is that you probably always had fucking hipster-ass IPAs and shit, and not just good old beers.
Yeah. That was actually a pretty good one. But either way, we were talking about Midsommar. So the night we went to see it, there was maybe like 10 other people in the audience. And at the end of the movie, this lady gets up and like storms out. And on her way out, she goes, "Man, that was stupid. I wasted my $8.
Yes.
And I was like, you sat here for 2 hours and like 30 minutes. And then you're... Okay, alright, dude, whatever.
It was pretty funny.
People who will sit there and tolerate stuff that they hate for 2 hours.
I mean, she paid $8, so she's gonna finish the movie.
Well, I guess this is a little hypocritical.
Maybe
she
was with it until
this.
The end. Yeah, I mean...
It's alright, I'm self-aware. I can realize when I'm saying something that doesn't match what I'm doing.
Yeah.
But, also, it's like, I think people went in there with expectations of something that the movie was not going to be, which I don't understand at all. It's like, y'all realize this is a horror movie by the guy who made Hereditary, like...
Yeah, well, I mean,
what are you expecting?
But it's also nothing like Hereditary, so maybe she was expecting it to be like Hereditary, you don't know.
Maybe.
Like, if you went into that movie expecting Hereditary, you're probably going to be really disappointed, you know?
But simultaneously, like...
I don't know why you would.
I went into that movie, so I intentionally watched no trailers,
yes.
I read no reviews, I fucking muted Midsommar on Twitter so no one would tweet something that fucked it up for me. Like, I
yes.
went to great
Oh, God!
Lengths. I mean, just murdered yourself. Ooh,
oh, my God,
that was
that
a weird
voice.
Death, y'all.
Oh, Jesus.
I went to great lengths to know nothing about this movie.
Yes.
So, that being said, I kind of figured it wasn't going to be anything like Hereditary, but that's okay, because you don't have to make the same movie
yes,
over and over.
Exactly.
That's kind of the whole idea.
I want
you to make something different.
This movie, I at least came out thinking, like, if someone hated this, I could completely understand where they're coming from, because, like, not everyone's gonna be into this, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I just see where if you don't get it, you're gonna think it's fucking retarded, you know?
Yeah, I guess so.
Especially because it's also hilarious.
It is
like,
really
that is
funny.
One of the things. If you see the ending things, like, some people, if they're laughing at a movie and they think it's supposed to be a horror movie...
Then they will think that means it's bad.
Yes, they think it means it's bad. Like, it's the same kind of people that can't appreciate something that's so bad it's good, you know? Where, like... they just see it, they go, oh, it's so bad, and they can't, like, connect in their head that what they're watching is actually good, because right. they are entertained, you know?
Correct.
If you are entertained, it is a good movie, regardless of whether you think it's objectively bad.
Right.
You could see a movie like Midsommar and confuse in your head, thinking that because other people, like, because the things that are happening are so ridiculous, clearly this is bad.
Right.
Even though I'm having fun,
because there's a layer
clearly
of absurdity,
this is bad.
It is
yes.
not good.
Because it's absurd, because it's grotesque, you know? And I can see, let's be real here, this was a middle-aged black woman.
Yeah.
Like, she's, I don't know why she came to see this
yeah,
in the first place.
Yeah, that's why, like, I don't get why you're here.
But, you know, she was going to see a horror movie, maybe she's into slasher stuff and not into watching a grown man fuck a 16-year-old girl while a bunch of women stand in and point at him
and
smack his ass.
And, yeah,
like,
and push his
I can see where there's where you might watch that, and depending on the kind of person you are and what you're willing to tolerate, maybe you haven't seen a Stanley Kubrick film before, you know? Maybe you'll think this is fucking stupid. I don't know.
I don't know, man. I mean...
Especially because it delves into the absurdity so hard that it's hard to believe that it's something that could really happen, even though it is. And that's
right.
why it's good, you know?
Exactly.
Like, that's part of why it's good.
Because I saw this movie once with Victor, and then I saw it again with my friend who I always see horror movies with.
Yes.
And, when we came out of the theater, she was like, so, do you think any of that shit ever, like, actually happened? And I was like... Yeah, it's, like, actually documented that that's
yeah.
based on real folklore. Like, real Swedish folklore, real Swedish, like, rituals. Like, some of that stuff actually did happen. Yes. And she's like, oh. Dude, yeah. You can go see,
yes.
like, the mallets in Swedish museums. Like, shit's real. It's just a completely different culture.
Yes.
Much like they emphasize in the movie.
Exactly.
It's a different culture from ours, so of course it's hard to understand.
And that's why the movie is very much like The Green Inferno.
Oh, I love I was thinking The Green Room. But Green Inferno
yes.
is pretty interesting,
Green Inferno
too.
is another movie that is mostly hilarious and stupid and awful, but also, it's a
hard
fun time.
Watch in the same way sometimes.
Yes. Because that one involves female genital mutilation, which is another thing that culturally...
Is
like,
real. It
yeah,
happens
Yeah, and in
still,
a lot of cultures,
now.
It's considered totally normal and not freaky at all.
Right.
But to us, it's like the most disturbing
right.
possible
that
thing you could imagine.
That is the most horrifying thing. Much
so
like
that is
things
one
that
of
happen
the,
in
one
this
One of
movie.
The interesting things about Midsommar is that it's like... It's one of those looking at a strange culture where to them everything they're doing is completely normal and not scary at all, you
exactly.
know?
Exactly.
Which is why it's good that it doesn't jump into the realm of, like, making them into something that's completely unrealistic in, like, a real Satanist horror cult.
Exactly.
Like, they're just doing weird-ass traditions that they think are totally normal
yeah.
and not scary to
they
them at
all.
They
grew up with this, so
yeah.
of course it's normal to them. And I mean, even if you ever read interviews with Ari Aster, like, it's the same kind of thing where he doesn't consider Midsommar a horror movie. He thinks of it as a fairy tale.
Yeah.
And I mean, that's because of the transformation that the heroine goes through. But still, it's not a horror movie because it's not meant to have
yeah.
that, like, oh, it's not horrifying in that same way.
Yes.
Not the way that Hereditary is.
Mm-hmm. It makes more sense as a fairy tale, like a Hansel and Gretel kind of thing.
Yeah,
you know, where it's
because,
not, like, overtly
you know,
scary. You're not, like, trembling
like
in your seat.
Fucking things like that happen in fairy tales,
yeah,
too, you know?
Exactly.
Like, fucked up shit happens in fairy tales. Grimm's fairy tales are nothing but fucked up fairy tales where people get their limbs ripped off and shit and their fucking toes chopped off to fit into shoes. Like,
yeah.
it happens.
That's what a lot of cultures are built on, you know? A lot of Greek mythology and stuff. It's, like, weird, gross...
People eating their own
crazy
children.
Shit. Zeus turning into animals and fucking them, you know?
Yeah.
Just like, that's just how it used to be in terms
exactly.
of storytelling. I have no idea what I'm doing right now.
All I know is you're supposed to be talking to
maybe I'm supposed to go back
town.
Up here.
That being said, I enjoyed Midsommar quite a bit.
Yeah, it's a great movie.
And now I get to look forward to seeing The Lighthouse at some point in the future.
Yeah.
And also, Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark is coming out in August.
Yeah, that'll
should
be
a,
cool
a lot
one.
Of fun.
It's a spooky movie.
Looks like it's got some good practical effects, which I can always enjoy. And
where are those guys? Like, fuck.
It
sucks so bad.
Oh,
there's like a bunch of ladies blocking this intersection.
Right, so clearly you're meant to do something over here.
Where are those guys?
Just talk to some townspeople and see what happens.
Are they back over here? I've talked to everyone.
Oh,
I'm
you?
Tired of going into places.
Okay.
Where are they?
I watched Bride of Reanimator, which was fun.
How's that? Talk about that movie.
If you like Reanimator, you'll probably
explain
like
what
Bride Reanimator,
Reanimator is.
Reanimator is a Stuart Gordon horror movie from the 80s based on an H.P. Lovecraft novel of the same name. Basically, it's about a mad scientist who is doing all of this testing on bringing back to life dead tissue. And for me, really, what sells the movie is the fact that the guy who they get to play Herbert West, the mad scientist, what's his fucking name? Jeffrey Combs. Jeffrey Combs is amazing as Herbert West. If he was not in these movies, I don't think I would enjoy them at all. But he does such a great job of portraying, like, this weird autistic mad scientist. It's so much fun to watch, and he's always fucking making snarky quips at people, and you're just like, this is so good. And it's got great practical effects. And in the first movie, there's a severed head
here
that licks a titty.
Yes.
So there is that.
I can't remember it enough. Because, you know, I don't remember anything about
my entire
life. Because
it
requires
the memory of a goldfish.
Because I'm mentally retarded.
That being said, of course, Reanimator is better, because Reanimator is actually directed by Stuart Gordon, who actually made good movies for a certain period of his career. And it is fucking badass. And if you have any interest in practical effects and horror movies, I highly recommend that you watch it. Bride of Reanimator, you should really watch more if you like the comedy side of things, because it's kind of much campier. It's directed by Brian Usna instead of Stuart Gordon. So even though Stuart Gordon was, I think, part of like the creative process, he did not direct it, so it doesn't quite have the same sense of quality. It's a little bit goofier, but it is a lot of fun. It's very much, I mean, this Bride of Reanimator is just Bride of Frankenstein. That's what it
of
is.
Course.
But because Herbert West is in it, that adds another layer of fun. There's a scene where a dog gets killed, and then Herbert West takes the dog's corpse and shot, like, because the dog had its arm ripped off, its front leg. And so he takes the dead dog, and he puts a human front arm on it and brings it back to life, and so the dog just has, like, one human arm.
All right.
And it, like, grabs this lady and chokes her. It's really
Jesus.
Funny.
Nice.
I found it very amusing. Either way, I haven't seen Beyond Reanimator yet. I would like to at some point. I've heard it's not very
Beyond
good.
Reanimator.
It went straight to sci-fi, apparently, in, like, 2000?
Straight to sci-fi in
2006 or something like that? So I'm sure it's going to be not nearly as entertaining as the first two,
it's like,
but
does it have anything to do with the H.P. Lovecraft story at that point? Or just
no,
nonsense?
At this point they're
like,
totally fucking spitballing.
What the fuck makes it even worthy of the title?
I think it might even have a different director. It's not even Brian Usna anymore. Mm-hmm. Not that it matters, because
just some
I'm
IP
sure it's going to be
exists.
Shit. It's going to be shit. It's a sci-fi, you know, original movie. It still has Jeffrey Combs as Herbert West, mm-hmm. but at this point, he's significantly older.
Yeah.
So it's not like he's the same, you know. He can't. It's just not the same. So I'm not in a big hurry to see Beyond Reanimator, but Reanimator and Bride of Reanimator, I can recommend.
I can look at the map.
Whoa, a fucking map.
Maybe the map will show me the way.
Hey, it's been 52 minutes, and I've been talking about a series of movies no one's seen in 30 years.
We need to get
through
the tutorial. I mean, what does it matter how long the episode is? Oh my god. This is just the worst. What do I do? Where do I go? What do I do? I think I need to go over here.
I did also see the Child's Play remake.
Yeah.
Reboot. I guess it's not a remake, it's a reboot.
Reboot of Child's Play.
I didn't hate it. It wasn't great. I won't probably ever bother watching it again, but it was alright. am not terribly attached to the original Chucky movies anyway. I think the idea of, like, a serial killer voodoo incarnated into a child's doll is kind of lame and edgy. And then his personality is super lame and edgy, so... there was no love lost in the fact that the crass, stupid serial killer personality was not in this Chucky doll. I had no problems with this.
Oh God. Why did they make this game? What were they thinking? No.
That being said, Victor, we should go see Crawl.
We should go see
starring
Crawl.
Starring a bunch of alligators.
Oh, there they are!
Oh, God. Finally.
Yeah, I did it. Yes!
Oh, my God.
We did it. We beat Skyward Sword.
Oh, Skyward Sword has been defeated.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I'm sorry, Frago. Wow, we helped this motherfucker and he lied to us. What a dipshit. What a fucking piece of trash. I hate him.
What?
We should throw him off the island.
What a piece of garbage. Oh my God, the text crawl is so slow. You can't just mash through it. Wait, it might go faster if I hold the button. What's going on? Oh, shit. Mm. Skip the tutorial.
Uh-oh.
Okay. I said something about the waterfall.
Well, we need to go to the waterfall to, like, save our bird. There you go. Maybe now those old ladies will be out of the fucking
One
way.
More thing!
There's dangerous things there. Ooh. So we need to go to, like, the Night Hall and get a weapon, I'm assuming.
Here we are, playing Tigger's Big Journey on the Nintendo 64. It's a fun time. God damn it, the stamina is the worst thing that's ever happened. It's so short.
Bad.
It's just this tiny little burst of energy.
Just like real running.
Fucking Nintendo. At least it feels more normal now that Breath of the Wild has been a thing. Because when it first, like, before Breath of the Wild, this was even more jarring and obnoxious to have the stamina bar, which had never been a thing in Zelda before. Such a great compounding of shitty ideas.
It's a really good addition, right?
How do I get in here? What do I need, the sword?
Read the sign. No kids allowed. You need to go get a sword first. Definitely.
I should have went into that building where those guys were.
Probably.
Let's talk to this idiot. Oh God, scary. Oh, fuck.
It's just a, like, telescope, that's all. There's nothing that exciting about it.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Well, speaking of going to the cinema... maybe now is a good time to talk about the biggest endemic problem that's ever been a blight upon movie theaters in the United States.
Oh, no.
Assigned seating.
Oh, fuck. The seating.
So that's recently, right. Some of our bigger movie theaters around here have adopted, the fucking assigned seating.
It's just the fucking Lynnhaven one. It's
no.
It's just the worst.
Regal does it, too.
Do they? Fuck.
Yeah.
God, that sucks.
The Regal near Town Center does it as well.
Jesus
fucking
Christ.
It's literally just military that doesn't do it.
It's like the apocalypse.
It truly is.
It's literally the end of the world.
If people weren't being driven out of theaters by high ticket prices before, they're going to drive us out of theaters with this fucking assigned seating bullshit. Because it is the biggest scam in the entire universe. Because when you go up and buy your ticket, in person... They literally have a little screen, and you have to look at the fucking seating chart of the theater on the screen and tell the ticket lady what seat you want to sit in. And chances are people have already bought tickets online and taken all of the good fucking seats.
Yep.
And the problem is, I don't want to buy tickets online through your app because then you charge me a $5 service fee. Oh, a service fee for using the internet. Fuck you, honestly.
Yes.
So that I can make sure I have a decent seat and these dumb fucks showing up to the theater with their $25 piece of pizza and bag of popcorn don't come through and be like, I'm sorry, you're in my seat. This is my seat.
We literally went to this theater and like, we have to pick our seats, and of course we have to pick the shitty seats because the whole middle of the row is taken. Even though we're like an hour early to the fucking movie.
Ugh.
We go in, we sit down wherever, because we're like, okay, well, that's bullshit. We're going to see, what were we seeing?
We were seeing Godzilla.
We're seeing Godzilla. I'm like, I don't know if it's going to be loaded. We're seeing this on like a Sunday or some shit, you know? So I'm like, all right, fuck it. We're just going to go take our own seats, do whatever the fuck we want. All right, let me see what this guy's saying. Hold on. Oh, it's in the back room. Great. Why don't you just give me the fucking sword, you piece of shit asshole? Fucking idiot.
God.
But yeah, so we show up fucking mega early, and then these people show up and they're like, they're our seats, so we have to scoot down, and we just sit in another couple of random seats.
Right.
And then this fucking people walk in, and it's this
now,
fucking...
Now, mind you, here's the thing. When those people walk in, the movie is literally starting!
Yes, the movie has
the
already
first
started.
The scene has commenced. The movie has started.
The movie has already begun, and these people are walking
in
with their fucking 30-pound popcorn and their stupid fucking pizza, and it's this
80-gallon jug of Coke.
Hold on. It's this cucked-looking motherfucker.
Oh,
this fat fucking soy-consuming piece of shit. And his fucking ugly, fat fucking bitch wife, where you just see in her face, like, you see them from the side of the aisle.
Yes.
And the guy, like, you can see the realization on his face that we're in their seat. And you see the sinking feeling that he has to deal with his wife. That
yeah.
He has to look at his wife, and he knows that he can't even suggest that they just sit somewhere else.
Right.
He knows what he has to do. And he knows that she will stomp on his fucking nuts if he doesn't do it. And he looks at her only for a second and sees the pure hatred in her fat fucking bitch eyes as they make eye contact, and her lip lowers to reveal her bottom teeth with that fucking awful bitch face look, gripping onto her 30-pound popcorn and her massive Coke. And she doesn't even have to say anything for that motherfucker's scrotum to crinkle and shrink into his body as his testicles are vacuumed up into his stomach. And he has to walk down the aisle and go, I think you guys are in our seats. And then I have to look at him, look at the desperation, the poor, sad, sorry desperation in his eyes, and then look at his fucking cunt wife and see the pure rage that she will have if we don't move, because it's all gonna be on him. This man's life will be hell if we don't move.
Oh, God.
So we just move to our shitty seats that we paid for.
I'm sorry.
The worst experience.
I just don't believe in this, like, fucking... It's bullshit. The movie theater's first come, first serve, you piece of shit. If I get there early, I get the good seats. That's how it fucking works. If you want to be a dipshit and show up 10 minutes before the movie starts and spend 10 minutes in line, spending $45 on fucking whatever dumb 15-pound bag of M&Ms and a fucking super-sized Sprite, then that's on you. That's on you if you want to walk into the theater right as the movie fucking starts and try to find a seat. But guess what, bitch? I've been here for 30 minutes. And that means, by the law of the fucking land, this is the United States of America, if I get here first, I get dibs. That's how we got this country. We weren't really here first, but, I mean, we kicked everybody else's ass, so it's our country now, and that's how it is.
Our country is clearly based on being a fucking fat, or the husband of an evil fat whore, and fucking just taking the land from people who rightfully own it. We're more like the Native Americans, okay?
Oh, God, yeah, I guess you're right. It doesn't mean we're wrong, though. I'm right. First come, first serve, bitch. How dare you?
Horrible.
How fucking dare you? Honestly, I ought to end your fucking miserable life.
Spin tag. Let's do it. This game is the worst. Yeah, right. Swing the nunchuck horizontally.
You gotta get vertical instead. Both of them. You gotta do both.
Oh, okay. This is awful. Okay. Is that it?
No, you okay. Didn't do it right.
I gotta do them both the same direction, I see. I just wiggled them.
Yeah, you gotta.
Furiously. Oh my god.
Fuck movie theaters is basically what I'm saying. They deserve to die out.
There we go. Theaters are the fucking worst. It's just what a shitty decision to make everyone miserable. Literally everyone. Except for fucking awful bitches who bought their ticket a day before and fucking chose their stupid fucking seat and then showed up late with their fucking popcorn.
Literally no one of any social merit benefits from this.
So you're that's like, the hold God's it high, truth. And then stab there, and then what, horizontal? Or am I just doing it? Oh, fatal blow.
Whoa.
Oh god, I hate this combat so much. Cause like, it's so annoying the way he just holds his sword forward like it's your Wiimote.
It is pretty funny.
It just feels really awful. Like, look
Whee!
At- What form is this? This is not combat!
Good, it's good form.
Hwa, hwa.
This is what real sword fighting looks like. You guys can't see what Victor is doing, but it looks like real sword fighting.
I'm basically, I'm ready for a fucking knife fight, dude.
Oh, hell yeah.
I'm ready for knife or death.
You gonna go try out for knife or death, my dude?
I am a pro at knife or death. No, I already learned the sword. Fuck you. I'm a master of the sword. I'm getting the fuck out of here.
I have to pee.
Okay, go pee. That's it for this episode of Vic and Hope.
Oh, are we done with the tutorial?
I mean, no, but you're going pee and I'm not gonna hold this on my own. 'Cause I can't hold it on my own.